गुरुर् ब्रह्मा गुरुर् विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः सच्चिदानन्दरूपाय विश्वोत्पत्यादिहेतवे तापत्रय विनाशाय श्रीकृष्णाय वयं नमः श्रीकृष्णाय वयं नमः ॐ योऽन्तः प्रविश्य मम वाचमिमां प्रसुप्तां सञ्जीवयत्यखिलशक्तिधरस्वधाम्नाम् अन्यांशहस्तचरणश्रवणत्वदादी प्राणान् नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यम् प्राणान् नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यम् प्राणान् नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यम् वी आर इन भागवतम चैप्टर 16 षोडशोध्याय एंड we are looking at the topic of glorious manifestations of the Lord. Explain. We are on verse 11, is it? So, 10. So, last week we saw where the Lord said that this question was asked to me by Arjuna, and to him also I answered something in the similar vein, and that's what I will tell you. And oh, chief among the insight into the meaning of questions, feeling like the common man that I am the slayer of the one of the other one is slain by me. What was the problem of Arjuna? He felt guilty of killing others. Why the terrorists don't feel guilty? Have you thought why they don't feel guilty?
They're
because
they are not attached to their body. They are willing to give up.
They are attached to the body. They are attached to the body.
What they do is right.
Huh?
They do it for a right cause. That's what they believe.
Something more than that.
They think they are not a doer.
No, they are the doer.
They are promised good life in the world.
That is also one part.
They are brainwashed.
Yes, all those is true. We also are brainwashed in our own way into thinking you are a wife, I thinking I am a swami. This is all brainwashing only. Because they don't feel guilty of their actions. And this is one basic principle of depression. Forgive yourself and move forward for whatever wrongs you have done in your life. Here, so two things we have to give up. What are they? One is guilt. Second is, I said it last time, you're forgetting. Expectations. Guilts of the past and expectations of the future. Arjuna's problem was the other way around. Expecting to kill all the people in the future, he's feeling guilty now. And so was his identity crisis, isn't it? That I am not a, here he says, what? That I am the slayer of the other one and the other one is slain by me. I am going to kill all the other people. And therefore, because of this, as someone said here, they are the doer. So thinking that he is the doer and believing that slaying one's own relatives for the sake of kingdom is not accepted by the society, will block his entry into heaven, will be ridiculed by the society in the future, his name will be bad, blah 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 blah. Isn't it? This is what our problem is. Whatever we do in our life is only for, I hope the other people don't take me in the wrong sense, isn't it? But if I have to, in a Sanskrit class, if I have to scold someone, I have to scold. Someone got scolding today. Huh? But again, at the same time, in some place, I was taking a Sanskrit class. They had studied with me for 3-4 years. 3 years, I think. Or 2 years. And one day I scolded them. And I scolded them. Meaning, scolding was how my displeasure or irritation that even after 3 years, you are not able to remember what you did in the first class. That is my frustration. And I, if you are a student, I have every right to be angry, isn't it? And they screamed back at me, literally. Swamiji, who do you think you are? We are grown up, matured people. Is this the way to talk to us? I said, what you are? I am so many years old. I am a mother of 2 kids. I am a father of 2 children. Is this the way to talk to matured, grown up people? I said, class over. Class over. After that, we did not meet. If you do not have the, not commitment, if you are not available to be corrected, then education cannot be transferred. This is the modern system where you assess the teacher. Where this teacher's report card, the school, all the students put together make. If they don't like it, they spoil the whole career of this teacher. That's not the way. And yet, there are kids and the class, the Saturday morning class or Saturday morning class. Now today's class. No, today was yours, na? Saturday morning class, first class. These kids in school holiday time, your class, in school holidays, they said, let's get together and continue with Sanskrit. And they came every day, out of 2 weeks, at least 8-9 days you guys came. So that inspires the teacher also. That all of them are interested. And you should have seen yesterday how much excited the kids were to do the exercise. It's before I was, they also got a bit of, you have to create the boundaries so that their mind, young kids, no, mind can get easily distracted. So why was that elderly person getting angry? Because they were not putting the effort to remember or to go through the exercise even before coming to the class. Can you afford to do that by going to work without knowing what you have to do? Can you afford to? You'll be thrown out of the job straight away. Within first warning, second warning, out. So today's class, new class. Whose class? Anyone here? Only one. Bhageshri. So they got a warning. Second class only, they got a warning. That if, Dad, remember, if you miss the class and don't do the homework, you have to pay me $10. If you come and do the homework and attend the class, it's free. good rule, no? So I'm going to be rich very quickly. A sure shot way of making your mind content from inside, unagitated from inside, not irritated from inside, is stop expecting anything in life. That does not mean that you don't plan, but stop getting expecting a particular result. Second, whatever the consequences are, don't feel guilty about them. Then what should we do? If you are not allowed to expect anything, we are not allowed to feel guilty about it. These are the only two things we know. We become anxious and panicky because of expectations, or angry because our expectations are not met. And after we do something, and if it brings a bad result or it doesn't bring the result that we want, we feel guilty that we should not have done it, or we should have done it some other way, etc., etc., isn't it? Then what do we do? Tell. Think. Then what do we do? I'm asking before we go ahead. Be 100% in the present, yes. Good. Do not take the ownership of action. Then what do you do if you don't take the ownership of action? If you don't know how to not take ownership, because we are so ingrained to think, I am doing this, I am speaking, I am listening, I came to satsang, I am going to make this food, I am, it goes on, no? All the whole day. And even if you are not speaking it in your mind, oh, I have to go to satsang, I have to make some subject for today. I have to make, isn't it?
Yes.
But that is the natural language, you will have to say that. So how do you get out of this catch?
Offer it to the Lord.
Offer it to the Lord, that He is the instigator of action, He is the instigator of thoughts, He is the instigator of everything in my life, including the breath. He is the giver of the results. If you are temporarily feeling guilty, no, He only brought it. Why? So that I learn something from it. What is to be learned? Forgive yourself. Simple. Or everything must come back to Samatvam Yoga Uchyate. You have to come into a stage where nothing matters, whatever is going on. But it doesn't. It should not become a state of overwhelming state or a depressed state. Instead, it should be a joyfully, who cares? Joyfully, that everything that is happening by His will. And this way you protect yourself from going into depression, just like Arjuna went. And there he says, why the today light is less here? Wo khol do zara window. Isko bhi khol do. Ab to dhoop chala gaya. This is nice. It was too. So he says, disillusioned by my reasoning, the tiger among the men then interrogated me at the van of fight in the same way as you have done. So Arjuna questioned Krishna Bhagavan as to the solution before he began fight, meaning you should question your motive, you should question your attitude, you must question your intention. Is it in the right frame before you begin any action? What was the action today? Of Bhagavat Pravachan, isn't it? How did we begin? Prayers. Isn't it? Every verse from Om Yonta from there till the end, it was all about invoking the divine, giving up the doership, creating an environment within our mind that everything that there is his, he alone, and it is his leela. And if there is at the individual level, Om Yonta Pravishya Mama Vacham Imam Prasuptam, that it is that divine alone who is everywhere, who is expressing through me as the speech, as the seeing, hearing, touching, feeling, tasting, acting, everything is he alone. At least start, even if it is not your experience, at direct experience at the moment, but at least start believing it. Sometimes you will remember, sometimes you will forget, sometimes you will remember, sometimes you will forget. Over a period of time, you will remember it all the time. Isn't it? So here he says, then he says, oh Uddhava. Now he starts telling him. So the only person who can remove this ignorance from our mind with regards to ourselves. What is the ignorance with regards to ourselves? That I am the doer. Another ignorance, expression of ignorance, I am the individual. Understand? There is nothing but divine. So this illusion of thinking yourself to be a teeny meeny aspect of this huge creation, this is why all the problems we are facing in our life. The moment you take reverse the position that this whole world is nothing, is zilch, is worthless in front of the self or Bhagwan, whichever way you put it, slowly the tide will start turning. As long as you feel you are a part of this world and the world is too big, coronavirus will catch you. But if you feel you are the master of this universe, it's not your experience at the moment, but if you at least start believing that this whole universe is made up of that divine, then coronavirus cannot do anything to you. It's mind over matter. You must, did you all go and collect all the stuff for the house? Huh? Nothing left. No toilet papers. Don't use it. Hand sanitizer is not a healthy thing to use because it takes away all your microbes, and then your hands are no immunity there. They are clinically clean, and that's not a healthy condition. And start using mug with water to clean your backside. Indian style. less paper will be used, less trees will be used. Now the whole world, see how beautiful our culture is. Without spreading it, automatically everyone is going to wash hands all the time. Bhagwan ki leela. So now in the 8th verse, he says, Bhagwan says, I am the self, the befriender and the ruler of all these created beings, O Uddha. In fact, I am all the beings as well as responsible for their birth, life and death. Now, you apply this on yourself right now. Don't think about two levels you have to understand this verse. One is birth, life and death of this body, of this thought, of this breath, of this action, and also at the totality level that this entire creation came into existence by the will of the Lord, it is existing by the will of the Lord, and it will go out of existence by the will of the Lord. And same thing is happening at the individual level also. Twofold. And then he says that, yes, last week we did that, I am the motion. Then he said, I am the time, the kala, And then what did he say? I am the equilibrium among the three gunas, sattva, rajas, tamas. So when does sattva, rajas, tamas express? When the equilibrium is lost. When does your mind get agitated? When it feels guilty or it expects. When does your mind get irritated? When it moves away from the center. When it forgets the Lord. When it stops contemplating. Whenever your senses and mind become extroverted, that very moment disturbance begins. Is there any disturbance in deep sleep?
No.
Why? Because mind has not become extrovert, the senses have not become extrovert. Where have they gone then? They have gone back, they have become unmanifest, or they have gone back to the source. Is there a way we can live like that in and through our daily life, continuously thinking of the source, contemplating on the source, and yet allowing action to happen? Can we bring that about? Yes or no?
Yes.
Give one example. I'm asking you people. Every one of you said yes. Give me one example.
Masters live.
Very simply, you are involved in something. When do accidents happen? When you are not alert. Not just attention. When you are not alert. So you are driving with attention, but you are not alert. One moment of unalertness and accident happens, isn't it? So have we cultivated our mind in such a way that even though the traffic of thoughts is going through the mind, but we do not forget the self, the consciousness, or the awareness, or the witnessing, or the Lord? This ability we have to develop. And you are listening to it here in the class, these young kids. If you develop it now, it will take you a long way in your life. But otherwise, you go, you see, in the nursing homes, which I don't know if you have ever visited nursing homes. Go and visit. You will start understanding what I am telling or Bhagavat is telling about this particular point. And how these people are dying there, where they have no one, and they are in depression in nursing homes. They are craving for company. They are irritated, shouting at nurses. And eventually, but nurses are strong, no? Then eventually, as the body gets older and older, they learn to succumb, surrender to the circumstances. Not joyfully. They learn to give in to the circumstances, that my children don't love me, there is nobody there for me in my life, this is what I deserve, and all the wrong conclusions, and eventually such people are dying out of depression. And yet you go to the mental asylum, there are many people who are always happy. They make the staff mad, but they will be happy. They're always happy, no matter what. So, live in your life in such a way that your sense of humor, your sense of wit, your sense of inspiration and motivation in life, your sense of joy towards life should never become less. Don't allow anyone to affect it. You have to take care of that mind in that way. You have to process your thinking in this way. Understand? Then when he says that the equilibrium of the gunas, I am, someone was telling me, not you, that young couple, you know, who came the other day, Sneha and Ramana, they came the Tuesday to my place. Swamiji, is it normal that if I don't sleep at night? This is what it is. Many of you must have experienced. Mind is having no thoughts. You are rested at night, but you were awake for some time. This is called equilibrium of the three gunas, where your mind is not... Because the moment equilibrium is disturbed, thought eruption will happen in the mind. If there is no thought, the three gunas are in balance and you are aware. So he says, I am the equilibrium. The next point after equilibrium, if the disturbance happens, what comes up first? Individuality or totality? That tariki. Totality. With the moment you well, it can, both are simultaneous, I should say, but it will be beneficial for us if we think totality came first. That is why we are going from individual to total and to infinite, isn't it? So who is the what is that totality? The totality is the Mahatattva. Another word for him is Hiranyagarbha is the womb. Brahma, no. Brahmaji, Hiranyagarbha, at our individual level, Hiranyagarbha will be the, Garbha means womb. What is the womb where, or the where in the womb the consciousness is reflecting? So where is the reflected consciousness? Chidabhas, it is reflecting in the mind, isn't it? Exactly the same way, at the totality level, where is the infinite reflecting in the total mind? What is that total mind? Hiranyagarbha. Not Ishvara. Ishvara is not a womb. Ishvara is is the principle, is the truth, the reality with respect to unmanifest gunas. But the moment gunas manifest, the first thing that comes about is Hiranyagarbha, the total mind, and consciousness expressing through total mind. Can mind come without consciousness? Can mind happen? The phenomena of mind happen without consciousness? Not possible. Can husband come about without wife? How do you know? I'm asking you. कौन है ये अपना बाबू है ना खुशाल बड़ा लग रहा है यार एकदम से एक महीने के बाद हाउ डू यू नो वाई हस्बैंड कैन नॉट कम विदाउट वाइफ यू हैव एक्सपीरियंस बट यू नो गुड सो हस्बैंड कैन नॉट बी विदाउट वाइफ सिमिलरली कॉन्शियसनेस माइंड कैन नॉट बी विदाउट कॉन्शियसनेस सो एट द टोटैलिटी लेवल That consciousness which is expressing through the womb of the total mind is called Mahatattva. Mahatattva, Mahat, greater than the greatest. Tattva, the essence. And which is this essence? The manifest total essence, the creator. Till here we saw last week. Now we go on from here. Then he says, I am the sutra, the active aspect of the Mahatattva, the very first evolute of Prakriti. Remember, listen to the words. the very first evolute means first evolution. क्या हो गया? वो कोई बात नहीं, वो तो चलता रहने दो, मुझे तुम नहीं डिस्टर्ब ना, बस फिर ठीक है. Then this was the 11th verse. We'll read it again. गुणीनाम अप्याहम सूत्रम महताम च महानहम सूक्ष्माणाम अप्याहम जीवो दुर्जयानाम अहम मनः. Then he also says, at the totality level, at the unmanifest level, it is Brahma, or the total mind level, it is Brahmaji. Then he says, सूक्ष्माणाम अप्यहम जीवो, at the total subtle level, he is the jiva. And then at the gross, and then where there is jiva, there has to be mind. He is the mind also. So he is this, the one alone is expressing through totality, individuality, and the instruments through which you are experiencing the world, which is the mind. Everything is him alone. Continuing from here, we begin today. हिरण्यगर्भो वेदानां मंत्राणां प्रणवस्त्रिवृत अक्षराणां अकारोऽस्मि पदानिच्छन्दसामहम्. In the 11th, 12th verse, he says, of the Vedas, is that the one? Of the Vedas, I am their teacher. So, of the Vedas, I am the teacher. So, who gave the teaching of the Vedas to the Rishi Munis? Lord himself. So, what do we say? They are Shruti, isn't it? The Vedas are Shruti. There is no other. There's no, and when we use the word other, we are talking in sense of human beings. There's no individual who has authored the Vedas, but it is the Lord's speech itself. So he says, where are we? Of the Vedas, I am the teacher, Brahma, who taught them for the first time to his mind-born sons. To whom did he teach? No, Brahma taught to whom? Sanat Kumaras. They in turn taught it to Narad Muni. Narad Muni in turn taught it to many others, but also Ved Vyas. And Ved Vyasa then expanded it for our benefit. And then it came down through the lineage of teachers. And today it has come down to you and me. So you are listening to the stories and the ideas presented there, and then you will tell it to your children. And this is how the whole thing from the top till now is till here it is going on, and all this is happening where? Within the Lord. It is not outside the divine, it is in the divine, and therefore it is beneficial for us to take it that this life is a leela. Don't be too serious about it. If you become serious, your immune system will go low. Seriously, I'm not joking. Because the hormones which are released when you are happy are different to when you are serious. Seriousness can take you to depression. Laughter and joyful existence can never take you to depression. It can take others to depression. What has happened to this fellow? Hota hai na kabhi kabhi. So in this way, then he says, of the mantras, the sacred texts, I am Pranava, the sacred syllable Om. See, Now, from the Vedas, Vedas are what? A collection of sutras. But among them, a collection of mantras, let's say. Out of the, all those mantras, what is the most important mantra? Om. See how slowly he's coming down and telling you in everything what is the most important. In Om Namah Shivaya, what is most important? Om. Om Namo Narayana, what is important? Om Aim Hrim Shrim Klim, what is important? Om. What is Beej mantra is Aim Hrim Klim. Om is not Beej. Om is transcendental. It is not Beej. Everything else can be Beej. Om is not Beej. See? So here he says, the pranava, the sacred syllable Om, consisting of three members, A, U and M. Of the letter sounds, I am the sound represented by the letter A. This is Vyageshri. What is A? It is a vowel or a consonant? Very good. I'm so happy. What type of sound is it? It is a? And what is a natural sound? Good. Natural sound is that which is independently existing within the creation and it does not need ka. It requires two parts of the mouth somewhere inside to pronounce it. Ja. It requires some two parts. Ta. The teeth are required. Pa. The lips are required. If you don't have lips, you so only a will come. Pa will not come. Try. Try pronouncing pa pha ba bha ma. You have studied that in Hindi. Try to pronounce it loudly without touching the lips. Can't, isn't it? What comes? Only the vowel comes. Do you require anything to say See, there he goes. Hey. Nothing. A child automatically starts. So what is the first sound that a child speaks or pronounces? So Bhagavan says, out of this A, U and Ma, I am the See how now we are coming from infinite, we have coming to the finite. And within the finite, the first expression is Therefore, vowels, yes, they come from the Om. Then vowels are A, I, E, I, O, U, R, U, R, U, A, I, O, A, U, A, M, A. Then consonants, K, K, G, 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 Ch, Ch, Ch. But what was the first vowel? Is the first vowel. That is the first expression of Om. In the manifest form. So here he says, I am that. In meters, I am the meter Gayatri consisting of 3 feet. Gayatri, it's a meter. I don't know, but we know Gayatri mantra, isn't it? Om Bhur Bhuvah Svah Tatsa Vitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya. But it is a meter also. Someone research and tell us next week. Do some research. Google. Not Google. Find out wherever. Google also. But not Wikipedia. Then, now the 13th verse. Huh? What is that?
Indroham sarva devanam vasu namasmi havyavat. Adityanam aham Vishnu Rudranam Nilalohitaha.
He says, out of the gods I am Indra. Now remember, at the totality level, who was the first god? Brahmaji. Right? From the total. Now from Brahmaji is greater than Indra, or Indra is greater than Brahma? Greater than Indra, isn't it? Then Indra is the lord of what? You know all the answers. Narayan Nam hai na isliye. मैं बोला था तो इंद्र इज द लॉर्ड ऑफ द माइंड. सो द लॉ सो फ्रॉम टोटल कॉन्शियसनेस वी आर कमिंग टू द टोटल सॉरी टोटल कॉजैलिटी वी आर कमिंग टू द टोटल सटलिटी. एंड हु इज द लॉर्ड ऑफ द सटल वर्ल्ड? इंद्रा. सो ही सेज आई एम द इंद्रा. हियर ही सेज व्हाट इज इट दैट I of the gods I am the Indra, their chief. Of the eight Vasus, of a particular class of gods, I am the god of fire who carries oblations to the gods. So where are gods? Where do gods exist for us? Where is their assembly all the time? In the, come on, you know, forget that. I am talking about total subtle. In the heaven. So Indra is sitting on the throne and all the Indra Devta, Agni Devta, Vayu Devta, all the Ashtavasus, etc. All of them are sitting there, isn't it? Out of them, who is important? Agni. Because can you pour water and the oblations will reach Indra? No. Can you offer Akshata and the oblations will reach Indra? No. Otherwise, air is also there, na? Chal bhai. Kya ho gaya? I've given the food to Indra. Aise to nahi hota na? Then what do? You invoke the fire. And in the fire, with the mantra, you put all the samagri. And through that fire, then it goes to Indra, isn't it? Similarly, when you are doing the shraddha, how does it go to the gods? How does it go? When you make, have you or anyone, you know about shraddha? That you make the pind? And how do you make? It should not be cold, it should be hot. Immediately it is made at that time and it is there and you do the puja. So how is it going? Through the hot steam, through the heat in the steam, that food, the nourishment is being offered to the pitras through the heat. Therefore Agni is the next one after Indra Bhagwan. Agni. That does not mean that others are less. They are not less. They are equally powerful. Then he says, who carries the oblations to the gods of the 12 sons of Aditi, I am Vishnu. So each one among the family, husband, wife, children, who is most important? Huh?
The eldest.
Diplomatic. Let me check which family the younger one is more important. So where are we? I am the Vishnu known by the name of Upendra, the youngest. What eldest? Youngest. The youngest, who appeared in the court of demon king Bali as a dwarf and robbed him of his dominion extending over the three worlds. This is among the Adityas. He appeared as the Vaman, that's the Vaman avatar. Then next verse, Brahmarshinam Bhruguraham Rajarshinam Aham Manuhu Devarshinam Naradoham Havir Dhanyasmi Dhenushu. In the 14th verse he says that of the nine Brahmana sages born from Brahma's mind, I am the Bhrugu Rishi, the foremost of them. Of the royal sages, I am the Swayam Rajarshi, royal sages, I am the Swayambhu Manu. of the celestial sages, I am Narada. And then, where are we? But we missed one part. Before that, Bali as a dwarf and robbed him of his dominion extending over the three worlds. Of the 11 Rudras, I am a Nila Lohita, Lord Shiva. And then, of the celestial sages, I am Narada. Of cows, I am the Kamadhenu, literally the storehouse of milk and its products used as oblation for the gods. You read the story of the interaction between Vishwamitra and sage Vashishta. You will come to see the greatness of Kamadhenu. She is Sarva Sampanna. Everything she can. Not only is she able to give milk and food and everything, but anything in this creation. So that Kamadhenu is what? It is your mind. It is the ability of your mind wherein whatever you want, your mind is able to manifest or create. Of the Kamadhenu, literally the storehouse. Okay, in the 15th verse, Siddheshwaranam Kapilaha Suparnoham Patatrinam Prajapatinam Dakshoham Petrunam Ahamaryama. Of the lords of Siddhas, I am the Kapila Muni, whose wife was Devahuti, was his mother. Of the birds, I am Garuda, the king of birds, the carrier of the lord of Siddha, no, Lord Vishnu. Of Prajapatis, the gods presiding over creation, I am Daksha, the foremost of them. Of the mains, that is the Pitrus, I am the Aryama, their head. Continuing, Mam Vidyuddhava Daityanam Prahladam Asureshwaram Somam Nakshatraushadhinam Gdhanesham Yaksharakshasam. Here he says, of the Daityas, the son of Diti, know me to be Prahlada, the ruler of the demons. Of the stars and annual plants, know me there a ruler. Know me to be their ruler, the moon god. So for the plants and etc., they, for them, moon god is more important than sun. Why? Sun can create photosynthesis, but the nourishment value in the plants comes from the light of the moon, not from the light of the sun. Then he said, kuch jal raha hai, something is burning.
Outside and next outside.
Okay. The moon god of yakshas and rakshasas, know me to be their chief, Kubera, the lord of treasures, O Uddhava. 17th verse, Airavatam Gajendranam Yadasavarunam Prabhum Tapatam Dyumatam Suryam Manushyanam Chabhupatim. He says that, all of the lord of elephants, know me to be Airavat, the carrier of Indra. Of aquatic creatures, know me to be their lord Varuna, the god presiding over the waters. Oh, of those emitting heat and light, know me to be the sun, know me to be the king among men. Me to be the sun, and know me to be the king among men. So who is, so that's why king is given the status of lordship. Then continuing, 18th verse, Uchaishravastu Ranganam धातूनामस्मि काञ्चनं यमः संयमतां चाहं सर्पाणामस्मि वासुकिः. I am the Uchchaishrava among horses. It was the Airavat also came out of churning of the ocean. Uchchaishrava also came out of the churning of the ocean. So he says, among the horses I am Uchchaishrava, among the metals I am the gold. Nowadays the price is going very high, no? Did you invest? No, Swamiji, lost the opportunity. Of the metals I am gold, of those that punish I am the Yamaraj, the lord of death, and of serpents I am the Vasuki, the chief of serpents. 19th verse. Nagendranam anantoham mrugendra shringidanshtrinam ashramanam aham turyo varnanam prathamonagha. Of the rulers of snake I am Lord Ananta, the serpent god of all animals having form or horns or large teeth. I am the lion, the king of beasts. Of the four stages of life I am Sannyasa. So in every aspect of creation Bhagwan is telling where is he specifically expressing, and you put your attention on that and you can come to me. You see, of the four stages of life I am Sannyasa, the fourth and the last stage. Of the four grades of society I am the very first, the Brahmana class. Brahmana class, class does not mean jati. Jati does not mean that you are born a Brahmana. Brahmana, who are Brahmanas? Who are Brahmanas? Those who put Nama and Tilaka and etc. and move around like monkeys. Seekers of truth are Brahmanas. And the basic requirement to be Brahmana is they have controlled their senses and mind. They may not know the truth, but their senses and mind are in their control. And because of that, they have sadhu bhav. They are forgiving. They are not running after the material wealth. So on one hand, they are not running after the wealth. Second, their senses and mind are under their control. Third, their attention is directed towards the divine. Such are those who want welfare of all are Brahmanas. And that idea of welfare for all will not come until unless we are surrendered to the Lord. Brahmana, Ravan was also Brahman. He was also wearing janeu. He also used to do puja. He used to do more havan than our Hanuman. He had more knowledge than this sannyasi. More knowledge. But was he a Brahmin? Born Brahmin, but conclusion Rakshasa. Understand? Prahlad, born Rakshas, Asur. But conclusion, Brahmin. Vashishta Muni, not Vashishta, Vishwamitra, born Kshatriya, conclusion, Brahma Rishi, ultimate Brahman. Valmiki, born Shudra, conclusion, Brahma Rishi. See, so it is not about what marks you are putting on your body. It is not about what action that you are doing puja. If you are doing puja, if you are giving lectures, if you are listening lectures, if transformation is not taking place, no point. And how will transformation take place? How will transformation take place? By some Mahatma touching your head. Such wonderful knowledge Bhagavat is telling us. So, How will transformation take place? Only by your Shraddha. Only by your Shraddha. Shraddha towards the scripture, Shraddha towards the Lord, Shraddha towards the lineage, how the knowledge has come to you. Shraddha towards the Lord who has given you this birth to remember him. Shraddha towards the Lord who is expressing through the teacher at this moment to explain to you. Shraddha towards your ability to understand the scripture as it is being told right here and now, not afterwards. So this Shraddha, meaning becoming available, that availability is what transforms you from the core. And that availability is not possible without reverence and faith. Any action you do, you cannot be good at anything if you are a thief. If you don't have faith in your ability, you will not be a good thief. You will not be a good thief. You are a martial artist, you are a dancer, you are a singer. Until unless you don't have this ingredient within your heart and mind of faith that I can be better than what it is happening right now, I will keep working towards it. Why? The Lord has given me the opportunity. The Lord is expressing through me. Why is he not expressing as he is? Why is the perfection still eluding? I have to become more available to him. That will again, you create that cycle within your heart and mind, that you keep surrendering. And the more you become empty, to that extent, the Lord expresses through you, Om Yontah Pravishya Mamava Chamimam Prasuptam Sanjeevayatya Akhila Shakti Dharasvadham Nam Anyashcha Hasta Charana Shravanatvagadin Pranan Namo Bhagavate Purushaya Tubhyam. Then this starts happening. Yontah Pravishya. Here it was a prayer, please enter. But if you are becoming available, it's automatically happening. And that's when Ratnakar, dacoit, becomes Valmiki. An arrogant king becomes Vishwamitra Brahma Rishi. See? This is the quality of a Brahmin. Continuously wanting to excel in life, to be the ultimate. Then he says, Dava, 20th verse, Tirthanam srotasam ganga samudra sarasamaham ayudhanar dhanuraham Tripuragno Dhanushmatam. Of all holy streams, I am the Ganga. Of all stationary waters, I am the oceans of the Samudra. Of weapons, I am the bow. Of the wielders of bow, I am Lord Shiva, the destroyer of the three cities. Sleepy? Go. No? Okay. Actually, it is good. When you are feeling sleepy, your mind is calm. And in that calm and empty mind, my words will be reverberating. You can't escape. Shift will happen. Either you will go mad or you will become intelligent. Choose. You can't choose also. Okay, continuing. We'll just read five verses. This is a long one.
Dishanyanamasmyaham meruhu gahananam himalayah vanaspatinam ashwattha aushadhinam aham yavah purodhasam vasishthoham ब्रह्मिष्ठानां बृहस्पतिः स्कन्दोऽहं सर्वसेनान्याम् अग्रण्यां भगवानजः यज्ञानां ब्रह्मयज्ञोऽहं व्रतानामविहिंसनं वायवग्न्यः काम्बुवागात्मा शुचीनामप्यहं शुचिः योगानामात्मसंशोधो मन्त्रोऽस्मि विजिगीषताम् आन्वीक्षिकी कौशलानां विकल्पख्यातिवादिनां श्रीणां तु शतरूपाहं पुंसां स्वायं भुवो मनुः नारायणो मुनीनां च कुमारो ब्रह्मचारिणाम्.
In the first verse he says that I am Mount Meru, among all abodes, of all spots difficult to access, I am the Himalayas. Of the trees, I am the Ashwatha, the holy fig tree. Of annual plants, I am the barley. Then in the 22nd verse he says, Purodasam Vasishtoham Brahmashtina Brahmishthanam Bruhaspatihi Skandoham Sarvasenanyam Agranyam Bhagavanajaha. Of family priests, I am the sage Vasishta, the priest of the ancient solar dynasty of kings. Of those devoted to the spirit of Vedas, I am the sage Bruhaspati. Who is sage Bruhaspati? He is the teacher of the gods, the Devas. Of the leaders of armies, I am the Skanda. Skanda, another name for Skanda, Subramanyam Swami, Kartikeya, Shanmukha, Skanda. Then of those that lead the men to right on the right path, I am the glorious Brahma, the birthless one. So he himself is Brahma, he himself is all the gods put together. In the 23rd verse, Yajnanam Brahma Yajnoham Vratanam Avihinsana Vayavyagnya Rakam Bhuvagatma Shuchi Nam Apyaham Shuchihi. He says, of all sacrificial performance, I am Brahma Yajna, the daily recitation of the Vedas. Of all sacred vows, I am the vow of harmlessness. How will harmlessness come about? Very simple. We say non-violence, isn't it? Towards whom are we most violent? Dad, mom? Give me my space. What does she say? Give me my time. You were telling me before, while we are having, what does she say? No. When you say, come on, do your homework, what does she say? Wo toh theek hai, school homework. But she does or no?
I do. School homework.
You do? What about Sanskrit homework? I will do. Where were we? So how are you practicing harmlessness when cockroach comes next to you, or you pick up the mortein, or you jump away somewhere? The most we harm in this creation is ourselves. So if you want to become non-violent, this is the lakshana of Sadhu Purusha. Don't harm yourself. So cultivate such thinking that you always remain happy. A happy person can never harm anyone. Isn't it? The first way, the moment you become unhappy, what is the first way you harm someone? By your bad speech, by your bad attitude, isn't it? Right? clicking. Away. Of purifying agencies, again, I am the purifying agency par excellence in the shape of the air, in the shape of air, fire, the sun, the water, and the words of a Brahmana, who is the only man qualified to judge and pronounce the purity of otherwise of a substance or a living being. So what is purifying? First is air. You do pranayam, all anomalies within your system, they get purified. Second is fire. Why fire? Anything you put into it becomes, it becomes ashes, isn't it? Next one is the sun. What happens? Sun removes the darkness. Similarly, when the sun rises within your third eye, this is an experience that people have on the path of Kriya Yoga or Kundalini. A point comes where you are continuously, the sun rises in your mind, literally it rises, and once it comes, the light is so bright that you can be in samadhi for few hours or 2-3 days, but after that your mind does not get corrupted to a large extent. Then next one is water. Water also purifies. Why it purifies? You wash dishes with fire or with water? You wash vegetables with fire or with water? Water. Huh? Why do you drink 8 glasses of water every day? What are you made up of? Water. 80% water. And the last one is, and the word of the Brahmanas. If you are, if you don't know any of the above, take the word. That is why we people go for initiation, isn't it? Swamiji, please give me initiation. And he puts the mantra into the ear of the child or the elderly, they give the mantra. And if that mantra was taken out of you go many places in Melbourne also, many people, even when Ammaji comes, oh, have you taken mantra for Ammaji? Have you taken Swamiji? No, I gave her mantra. It's a competition. Who has got mantra and who has not got mantra? It's comparison. What is the purpose of mantra to be taken from Ammaji or from any other great master? What is the purpose? That you chant it with faith and it will purify you. How will it purify you? Vaikari Madhyama Pashyanti Para. From gross speech to subtle speech, subtle speech to causal speech, causal speech to transcendental speech. When it reaches transcendental speech, what will happen? You will come to the source of the speech. What is that? And in this between, you will see the sun also. But then eventually, what is the source of speech? We saw before. Om. You will hear Om. Before you hear Om, you see, hear many other things. But if you remain focused on the words of the initiation, you keep chanting that mantra in spite of all distractions, the experiences that are happening on the seat of meditation, then you will go beyond that, beyond Om also. It will go and deliver you from where it has come. Then next one, yajnanam karliya, yoga naam atma sanyo samrodho mantrosmi vijigishyatam anvikshiki kaushalanam vikalpas khyati vadinam. In the 24th verse, he says, of the limbs of yoga, self-discipline, I am samadhi, absorption of the mind into the spirit. So, I am doing samadhi. Can you do samadhi if mind is absorbed in the spirit? Can you practice samadhi? Then what do you practice? You practice going to the seat of meditation. You practice focusing your mind. You practice emptying your mind. You practice tada drashtuhu swarupe avasthanam. That before the mind becomes empty, you are bringing your attention of the mind towards the one who is watching. The mind had so many thoughts before. Now it has only one thought left. So when samadhi happens, is there dialogue going on in your mind? Just like when you go to sleep, is there a dialogue going on in your mind? No. In samadhi also, no dialogue is going on in your mind. But the difference is, in sleep, you are unaware of yourself. In samadhi, you are aware of yourself. So, absorption of the mind in the spirit. I am political wisdom in those that seek victory. Of all scientific courses of correct understanding, I am the science by which the distinction between the matter and spirit is known. What is this? Viveka. Vivek means discrimination. Discrimination means separation. What is science? What is science? What is a specialist in today's language among the doctors? Who is specialist and who is a GP?
Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
Bolo Krishna Kanhaiya Lal Ki Jai. So we are talking about what is general and what is specialized. General is knowing more and more of more. Specialized is knowing more and more of less and less. So common sense goes out of the window as you become specialist. But science or spirituality is not like that. You are going from many thoughts to less thought, going from many to less. From many subjects to less subject, isn't it? When it is practiced in the outside world, in the materialistic world, your knowledge becomes specialized and general knowledge goes out of the window. But in the spiritual path, when from many thoughts you come to one thought, exactly the opposite happens. You start getting the knowledge of everything. This is the difference. So, here he is told that discrimination is between the truth and the untruth. What is discrimination? Differentiating in your daily life, even while functioning in life. What is permanent, what is unchanging as compared to what is impermanent and what is changing. Remaining aware of that, not as a concept. Everything is changing. Keep analyzing. World is changing. Eyes are the same. Senses are changing. Mind is the same. Thoughts are changing. Consciousness is the same. Slowly, slowly, come back to the consciousness. And in this manner, we come to the 20. Then, I am the unending doubt of those debating on the theory of perception. So, Bhagwan is saying, not only I am the solution, I am also the doubt. And what is the and he expresses the doubt among whom? Who are finding, how did this creation come about? There's no answer. There's no straight answer to it. Where did the dream world come from and where did it go? It's a matter to be discussion. Let's have a group discussion on it with no conclusion. Cannot be. Every person has his own take on it. Every religion has his own take on it. Our Bhagavatam has, they say, or we must have gone through, 88 different types of creation are given in Bhagavat. Does not mean there are 88 types of creation. It means talking about creation and finding that where it came from is a foolish pursuit. Phenomena has no reason. Phenomena happens under certain circumstances, isn't it? Where did the mirage come from and where did it go? There's no answer. Under certain circumstances, until unless the amount of moisture in the air, the angle of light, the position of the sun, etc., etc., is not there, you cannot get mirage waters. Try to do it in the middle of the day, you cannot create mirage waters. Isn't it? No, when I put the stick in the water, it seems to be broken. When I take it out, it becomes straight. Magic. How can I want a broken stick when it is out and becomes straight inside? You cannot make it happen. Phenomena. See? Continuing. So don't try to find out. If you put your mind to this question, many people, because see, in the Western religion, their world began only from the birth of, from the death of Christ or birth of Christ. From the birth of Christ. So as if the world was not there before or what? Isn't it? So they have a problem. Why? When the world ends, so they want to preserve the body. This, the second awakening. So we don't care, burn it, finish it off. It doesn't matter. And those who are very much worldly oriented, for them this question is, why so many people are dying, why governments are corrupt, why people are like this, why people are like that, why people are not sensitive, why people gossip, why people can't be good and talk, why they only talk about other people, why people can't talk good. Why governments cannot be, it's such a beautiful planet, why can't they live peacefully? If everyone knows planet is the only place where we can live, then why can't we take care of the planet? Isn't it? When we know there is, people say, government says there is shortage of water. So then after knowing, then why do you waste? Why people waste? And then you go into their house, they are the first culprit. They are wasting water. What will happen to this world? And you don't even segregate your garbage to put in the garbage bin. And you are talking about what will happen to this world. What responsibility have you taken? Have you corrected your actions? This is all because of thinking about the world. And there are no permanent solution for this world. It's a play of cause and effect. Something will be good, something will be bad. Another time, good seems to be very prominent, bad is less. Another time, bad is prominent and good is less. And life goes on. The world keeps on going like that. Satyug, Tretayug, Dwaparyug, Kalyug. Isn't it? Is your day, every day a good day? Or some days? I didn't ask you. You have to have a good day every day. Suddenly, yeah, good day, good day. So every day, someday it is a bad day, someday it is a good day. So same way in society also, every day cannot be a Ram Rajya. Every day cannot be a Ram Rajya where there is no war. There will be some time. Sometime it will not be there. So there are no permanent solutions to the world. And when you talk about this world, you will always remain in doubt. That doubt is expression of the Lord with regards to the perception of the world. Now understand? Arre yaar, phir se doubt aa gaya. Bhagwan kya leela kar rahe ho? You are putting doubt in my head. So by doing this, by saying that I am the doubt in those who perceive the world, what is he telling you? That when there is a doubt, come to recognize this doubt has been sent by or is expression of him. So your attention goes back to him, not to the doubt.
Oh, Lord.
Goes back to the Lord. And once your attention goes back to the Lord, automatically the doubts and incomplete knowledge automatically gets sorted out. As you come closer to him, as you come closer to heat, automatically the cold that you are feeling starts going away. You didn't do anything. All you did was come close to heat. The darkness in the room automatically goes when you put the switch on. Exactly the same way. The more you think of the divine to that, directly proportional to that, the darkness in your mind equal to ignorance is equal to worldly oriented mind. It will slowly get reformatted by his grace. Enough of that. Now in the 25th verse, 24th ho gaya yaar. Streenam tu shatarupaham punsam swayam bhuvo manuhu narayano muninam cha kumaro brahmacharinam. Of the fair sex I am Shaturupa, the wife of Swayambhu Manu, and the first female offspring of Brahma. Of men I am Swayambhu Manu, the first human male creation of Brahma. Of ascetics I am the sage Narayana, and of the celibates Sanat Kumaras. Continuing, we'll finish it quickly today. Dharmanam asmi sanyasaha kshemanam bahirmatihi guhyanam sunrutam maunam mithunanam ajastvaham. In the 26th verse he says, of all virtues I am the vow of causing no fear to anyone. I have to learn that in my Sanskrit class. Not to. Now, Ed, are you afraid of me in the class? That's a problem then. Yeah, show it to me at least. My ego will be caressed that I am, someone is afraid of me. Nobody is afraid of me. No. So, our demeanor, our speech, our interaction should be such that everyone feels comfortable. Nobody becomes afraid of your presence. Then I am the, where are we? causing no fear to anyone. See, we are not causing fear to anyone. In your intention is not there to create fear. If someone else is feeling the fear, that's their problem. You understand? Sometimes Mahatmas are there, they are full of love, isn't it? Ammachi hugs everyone. But look at their brahmacharis. Go to other ashrams also. The Mahatmas may be absolutely no thing inside, but they are afraid. In our ashram also, when we were studying, only two or three of us were not afraid of Swamiji. Everyone else were afraid. So if Swamiji has, because six classes every day, and he used to get migraine, and sometimes he used to forget in the pain that he has a class. So who will go and tell Swamiji, Swamiji, we are running late, we have a class. कि सबकी फटती थी तो कौन जाएगा ब्रह्मचारी जाएगा तो आई यूज टू गो देन आई विल गो दे यूज टू अफ्रेड बाहर से देख के आ जाएंगे वापस अरे जाके नॉक करो ना एंड फियर डोंट लिव इन फियर इन लाइफ ऑफ एनीथिंग और एनीवन सो वेयर वॉज दैट फियर Same person, we are not feeling afraid, others are feeling afraid. So is it he instilling fear in us or because of our processing of him in our mind, we are fearless or fearful? Correct? Are you fearful? So right, there are so many people. Your interaction with coronavirus will determine whether you are afraid of it or not. If you keep thinking about it, keep listening to the news. Oh my God, it's spread. Yesterday it was 80 countries. Today it is 81 countries. Yesterday it was another 150 people got infected. Only it happened in Glenway Valley. It happened in here. It happened there. Oh my God, it is coming closer and closer to my house. And you live in fear. And what is... So why is it coming closer and closer? Because you are inviting it. You are inviting it. Huh? It's not omnipresent. Don't give it a name, omnipresent. In Marathi, we say, "Bol rahe na rahe, tar bolla." Omnipresent only one, Bhagwan. Nobody else. Keep that information to yourself. Don't tell others. No, seriously. Talk positive. Virus is not omnipresent. There's only one thing which is omnipresent, and that is that which is permanent is omnipresent. Is virus permanent? Or it has come and it will last for some time and it will go. So what logic is there that it is omnipresent? I have to say that strongly. Because this is how, jokingly, I'm not pointing you, we are all guilty of it. Jokingly, we put wrong ideas in our mind and we think this is just, you know, majak mein bol diya. In joke, you are happy. And in happiness, if you have said something wrong, it goes and bloody sticks inside deep in your subconscious. You don't say jokingly, I am Bhagwan. I am pervaded by Bhagwan. I never heard anyone. Coronavirus is omnipotent. So which means you are pervaded by it already. Socho, uska consequence. Kya time ho gaya yaar? Time kya ho gaya?
20
minutes. Okay, 10 minutes, we'll quickly finish this. Because this is all stories. Of the ascetics, I am the sage Narayana of this end of celibate Sanat Kumara. Of the virtues, I am the vow of causing no fear to anyone. Of all factors conducive to fearlessness, I am the thought withdrawn from without and directed towards one own self. So how do you instill fearless in your mind? Remember what I was telling you before? The more you are thinking about the world, fear will enter. The more you withdraw from the world and focus towards the Lord, automatically, just like that cold left you as you came close to the heat, similarly, fear will leave you as you come towards the fearless principle, which is the divine itself. And where does fear express? Where there is two. And what is Lord? All-inclusive principle. So as you keep thinking of the all-inclusive principle, fear goes. No collection of toilet papers. Yeah. You can take newspaper, no problem. पेपर में और कुछ भी आता है, सैंड पेपर भी आता है. Okay, where are we? Where, which one we are on? 27. Samvatsarosmya nimisha rutu nam madhumadhavau masa nam marga shirshoham nakshatranam tathabijita. In the 27th verse he says, of those that ever keep awake without even winking, I am the ever-evolving wheel of time represented by the 12 months of the 6 seasons constituting a year. I am the 2 months of Chaitra, Vaishakha, of the 12 months of the year. I am the month of Margashirsha, and of the 27 lunar mansions, I am Abhijit. Continuing 28th. Aham, we'll read up till 38th quickly. Aham yuganam chakrutam dhiranam devalosita dvaipayanosmi vyasanam kavinam kavya atmavan vasudevo bhagavatam tvam tu bhagavateshvaham kim purushanam hanuman vidyagranam dhudarshanah ratnanam padmaragosmi padmakosha supeshasam kushosmi durbhajatinam gavyamajam havishvaham vyavasayinam aham lakshmihi kitavana chalagraha titikshasmi titikshunam satvam satvavatam aham ojasaho balavatam karmaham vidhi satvatam satvatam navamurtinam adimurtiraham para vishvavasu purvachittihi gandharvapsarasamaham bhudharanamaham sthairyam gandhamatramaham bhuvaha apam rasascha parame paramaha tejishthana vibhavasuhu prabhasuryendu taranam shabdoham nabasah paraha brahmanyanam baliraham veeranamaham arjunaha bhutanam sthitirutpatti aham vai pratisankramah gatyuktyut sargopadanam anandasparshalakshanam aswadashrutyavagranam aham sarve driyendriyam prithvi vayurakasha apo jyotiraham mahan vikara purusho vyaktam rajas sattvam tamaparam ahametat prasanskhyanam jnanam tattva vinischayah mayeshwarena jivena gunena gunina vina sarvatmanapi sarvena na bhavo vidyate kvachit. Now let's quickly see what it all means. We'll just read through it. Of the 4 yugas, I am the Kruta or the Satya Yuga, and of the self-controlled, I am the sages Asita and Devala. Of the compilers and arrangers of the Vedas, I am the sage Krishna Dvaipayana. Of wisdom, I am the self-possessed Shukracharya, the preceptor of the demon kings. Of the divine personages, I am the Vasudeva, the first and the foremost of the 4 vyuhas or manifestations of the Godhead, the deity presiding over the intellect or chitta. Vasudev, that's another time I'll tell you. I think we have already covered. Who was Vasudev? Who was his son? So first was Vasudev. His son was Vasudev. His son was? Krishna's son was? Pradyumna. Pradyumna's son was? Aniruddha's son was? I don't know. So, Now, if you remember at the time of birth of Krishna, Bhagavan Krishna, what did we say? If Krishna needs to take birth within you, what are the two ingredients that are required? Vasudev and Devaki. Who is Devaki? Pure mind. And what is Vasudev? Pure intellect. Until unless these two don't come together, the advent of the divine will not happen in your heart. When we say Vaikari Madhyama Pashyanti Para, Para is that Vasudev, and the mind has been purified from gross to subtle, subtle to causal, and we are now going beyond causal. It's completely purified of sattva, rajas, tamas. And my intellect is totally focused on the divine. It's not getting lost in any other convictions except having complete faith is not in the mind. Faith is in the intellect, in your, where you make choices. That is where the intellect resides, Shraddha resides. Shraddha is not a feeling. Bhav is a feeling. So, he says among the, where are we now? I am Lord Vasudev, and then the deity presiding over the intellect or chitta, and of the votaries of the Lord, I am you, Uddhava. Votaries of the God, Lord, those who talk about the Lord, explain the Lord, spread the name of the Lord. Who is the one? Uddhava. So now he's given a status to Uddhava also, that he is not other than him. Oh, of Kimpurushas, a species of semi-divine beings resembling a monkey in shape, I am Hanuman, the monkey god. Of Vidyadharas, heavenly artist, I am Sudarshana. Of precious stories, I am the stones, I am the ruby. Of lovely objects, I am a lotus bird. Of the many varieties of Darbha grass, I am the Kusha and Durva. I am the variety known by the name of Kusha, of offerings thrown into the sacred fire. I am the cow's ghee. Of those engaged in any business and seeking to amass wealth, I am the wealth. In those engaged in practicing trickery, I am gambling. I am the endurance in those practicing endurance. I am the courage of the courageous. I am the organic strength as well as the strength of mind of the strong. And know that I am the action done by the way of an offering to me. So, Brahma Arpanam, Brahmavi. So, everything is Brahman. The action also, also is Brahman alone. And in this way, where are we? I am the, by the offering of the devotees of the Lord, of the nine forms, Vasudeva, Sankarsana, Pradyumna, Aniruddha, Narayana, Hayagriva, Varaha, Narsimha and Vamana, worshipped by the Satvatas, followers of the Pancharatra Agama, I am the first and the highest of them, Vasudeva. I am the Vishwa Vasu of the Gandharvas, the celestial singers, and Purva Chitti of the Apsaras, celestial nymphs. I am the firmness of the mountains and the pure odor of the earth. I am the sweet taste of the water of the most glorious. I am the fire. I am the brilliant light in the sun, the moon, the stars. I am the sound, the distinguishing property of ether. I am Bali. I am Bali among those devoted to the Brahmanas of the Valiant. I am Arjuna. I am the genesis, existence and final dissolution of created beings. I am the function of locomotion, speech, defecation, grasping and enjoyment of the organs of action and touching, seeing, tasting, hearing, smelling of the senses of perception as well as the faculty of perceiving of sense objects inhering in all the senses of perception. I am the seven categories which are both of the nature of cause and effect, subtle, that is the subtle elements of earth, air, water, fire, the cosmic ego and the Mahat Tattva, the principle of cosmic intelligence, the 16 categories of which are modifications alone, that is the 5 gross elements and the 11 Indriyas, the soul which is neither a cause nor an effect, the unmanifest primordial matter which is a cause alone, the 3 modes of Prakriti which is Sattva, Rajas, Tamas, as well as the Brahma, the Absolute. Nay, he comes to the 38th verse, he says, no, not only that, I am the numbering of these categories, their distinguishing knowledge by means of their characteristics and the resultant realization of truth. Nothing exists anywhere apart from me, who am God, as well as Jiva, the individual soul, the 3 gunas, as well as the categories made up of the 3 gunas, that is the Mahat Tattva and so on, which we explained in the beginning of this explanation. Who am I am myself, the inner controller, as well as all that is there to be controlled. So in other words, I am all that there is. See, similar thought is expressed when we chant Rudram. In Rudram, in the Namakam, everything in this creation is mentioned, that Bhagwan is space, air, water, he is the Indra, he is this, he is Agni, every same wordings. And then Chamakam comes. What is Chamakam? That everything that you are, which was given in Namakam, may you bless me with it. That is Chamakam, Falashruti. So where is the question of individual? Where is the question of him, you seeking him specifically somewhere? Go for pilgrimages, go to temples, light the lamp, listen to Bhagavata or Upanishad, etc. But understand, he is everywhere all the time. And how he can come close to you? The moment you think of him, that very moment, he is right next to you. Radha thinks of Krishna and Krishna is there next to him, because she's calling him, thinking of him without any doubt. One hand, without any doubt. On the other hand, unconditional faith that he and me are not separate. Why? He said so. That also, he said so. Therefore, whenever she thinks of Krishna, Krishna is immediately on her side. Continuing last few verses, quickly we'll finish. Sankhyanam paramanunam kale na kriyate maya na tathame vibhutinam srijatondani kotishaha teja shri kirti aishwarya hristyaga saubhagam bhagaha viryam titiksha vijnanam yatra yatra sameshakaha etaste kirti tam sarvaha sankhepe sankheyena संक्षेपेण विभूतयः मनोविकारा एवैते यथा वाचा विधीयते वाचं यच्छ मनो यच्छ प्राणान् यच्छेन्द्रियाणि च आत्मानमात्मना यच्छ न भूय कल्पसे ध्वने यो वै वाङ् मनसि सम्यग् असंयच्छन् धिया यतिः तस्य व्रतं तपोदानम् स्रवत्याम घटां ब्रुवत तस्मान् मनोवच प्राणान् नियच्छेन्मत्परायणः मद्भक्तियुक्तया बुद्ध्या ततः परिसमाप्यते ओमिति श्रीमद्भागवते महापुराणे पारमहंस्यां संहितायाम् एकादशस्कन्धे षोडशोऽध्यायः 39th verse. The reckoning of atoms can be done by me in course of time, but not so of my glorious manifestations, which are endless as I evolve universes in tens of millions. this is not the only universe. N number of universes are there. Where are they? Where are they? Outside? Yes, outside also. But where is outside? Where is outside? In your mind. And where is the mind? Part and parcel of the divine. He also is, he is himself there, no? So, I evolve universes in tens of millions. Wherever there is glory, remember this, wherever there is glory, affluence, renown, authority, modesty, liberality, elegance, good luck, valor, endurance, and knowledge of truth, that is indeed my part manifestation. It is not prarabdha. I have become successful. I must have done some good deeds. That's why I am successful. I must have done some punya. Therefore, I am successful. That's why good things are happening in my life. No. Good things are happening in your life because by His grace. Bad things are happening in your life because of His grace. Good things are happening because you are using your punya. He is utilizing your punya. And if bad things are happening in your life, He is utilizing your demerit points. These are all my glorious manifestations made known to you in brief. They are, however, mere caprices of the mind and not real. So, Bhagavan is saying that all these expressions of the Lord in His 10 avatars, etc., Adityas, Vasus, the whole creation, everything is not real. Then what is it? It's a projection. Projection of His Shakti. And therefore it is when He expresses through it, He says it is only a Leela. Merely expressed in words. Because there are words, then idea has to present there. If we say Krishna, it has to be there. If I say Daksha, then person has to be there. If Daksha was not there, then I say Daksha, some other Daksha will be there. But something has to be there. Therefore, rest now. This is the sadhana that is given. Therefore, restrain your speech, curb your mind, control your breath, tame your senses, and conquer your intellect with your sattvika intellect, and you will no longer be able to return to the path of transmigration. Remember what Govindananji said? Sharir se seva karo. इंद्रियों को संयम में रखो. मन से प्राणी मात्र के प्रति सद्भाव रखो. बुद्धि से सद्विचार करो. और who is owning the four बुद्धि, मन, इंद्रियाज एंड शरीर, who is owning? अहंकार. अहंकार से निरहम बनो. These are the points in short given here. Think about them. The sacred vows, austerities and liberality of the yogi who does not duly subdue his speech and mind with his reason leak out unnoticed as water from an unbaked jar. Remember the story of the crack pot? Our Namdev Maharaj. Therefore, keeping his eyes fixed on me as his goal, a man should control his mind, speech and breath by means of his intellect, full of devotion to me. Thereby, he will have reached the end of his journey. Harihi Om. We'll talk about these 42 and 43 and 44 verses again in our next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnah Purnamudachyate
पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरिः ओम। श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ओम।